Welcome to Phoenix Medical Lectures. In today's video, we will be seeing about keratoconus. So keratoconus is a non-inflammatory condition. Also, it is bilateral. And it is an ectatic condition. So keratoconus is a non-inflammatory bilateral ectatic condition of the cornea. So actually the etiopathogenesis is not clear, but the various theories that have been put forward regarding keratoconus is that it might be a developmental condition, a degenerative condition, or an endocrine anomaly. So the pathological changes So the main pathological changes in keratoconus are two main factors. One is ectasia, and the second one is stromal thinning. Thinning of the stroma and ectasia are the two major pathological changes. Next. Coming to clinical features, in the clinical features, first we'll see symptoms. Again, two main symptoms. There is myopia, which is progressive, and astigmatism, which is irregular. So progressive myopia and irregular astigmatism are the two main symptoms. So if we divide it into blurring of vision and loss of vision. Blurring of vision is associated with glare, halos, light sensitivity, and ocular irritation. So blurring of vision is associated with glare, halos, light sensitivity, and ocular irritation, whereas loss of vision, there are two causes, primary and secondary. The primary cause is again astigmatism, and myopia, and the secondary cause is corneal scarring. So coming to the important part, the signs. We'll see one by one. The first one is window reflex. So window reflex is distorted. The second one is placebo disc examination, and here the circles are arranged in an irregular pattern. The third one is slit lamp examination, and there are a lot of findings: ectasia, opacity of the apex, fissure ring at the base, folds of Bowman and Decimans membrane. Next one is retino scopy. So retinoscopy shows an important reflex which is the yawning reflex or scissoring reflex. The fifth one is distant direct ophthalmoscopy. So in distant direct ophthalmoscopy, there is another reflex known as the oil drop reflex. So in this, there is a dark annular shadow between the center and the periphery of the cornea. The next one is the Munson's sign. So this is the lower lid margin. When the person with keratoconus looks down, there will be a bulging of the lower lid. This is known as Munson's sign. Next is keratometry. So the normal value is 45 diopters, and in keratoconus, mild, moderate, and severe. Mild is less than 48 to 54 is moderate, and more than 54 is severe. finally, corneal topography. In corneal topography, we see the shape. So the diagnostic subclinical form of keratoconus that we detect is known as formae frustae. This is the subclinical form. Now coming to the classification, there are three: nipple, oval, globus. So this is less than 5 millimeter. This is 5 to 6 millimeter. This is more than 6 millimeter. And the shape, this is steep curvature. This is ellipsoid. And this is globe. So the complication is acute high drops, which is caused due to decimates, membrane rupture. Now finally coming to the treatment. First one is spectacle. This is for the early forms only, but in later stages we cannot correct keratoconus with spectacles because of astigmatism. The second one is contact lens. Rosé. Okay, again, this is also for early to moderate cases. The third one is intacts. These are intra corneal ring segments. Intracorneal ring segments, again, these are also for early to moderate cases. Next one is corneal collagen cross-linking with riboflavin. Corneal collagen cross-linking with riboflavin. So this is done to slow down the progression of the disease. And finally, keratoplasty. This we do for the later stages. We do two types of keratoplasty: deep anterior lamellar keratoplasty and penetrating keratoplasty.